want to be wealthy, you got to study wealthy people. It's not hard. They say success leaves clues. But you've got to overcome fear if you're going to win. Talk a little bit about that, because I think a lot of people miss something like this that says, if you want to be wealthy, you got to study wealthy people. It's not hard. They say success leaves clues. And so two things, man, studying successful people and you always say wealth begins in the mind. Talk about how we can help people get to that wealth mentality first so that they can start some executing on the actual wealth building.
Yeah, it's about tapping in, man. You know, you won't know that it's available unless someone comes into your life and at least tries to, you know, knock you upside the head. But it starts with wanting better. You know, you have to actually want better to then start to attract better and to see better. Right. So if we don't have that inkling in our spirit that things can be better or things can or that I can increase my income or that I can acquire assets, if we don't have that desire, then those opportunities, although they're around everywhere, you'll never see them because you're not attracting them to you. But once you get the want, then, the good Lord starts putting angels and people across your path to be able to satisfy that desire that you have, which hopefully turns into building wealth for yourself, your family, and the community. But once you get to the want phase, I mean, once you get to the want phase, like seriously wanting it, it's one thing to have lip service. It's another thing to have a desire. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people can repeat what other people have said, but it's another thing to have it in your heart. Like, man, no, you know what I'm saying? In your heart, is there this thing right. called resolve? And then once that happens, you know, good Lord starts to put people around your path. He starts to put books in front of you, you know, new television stations, all this stuff. Like, oh man, it turns into a whole new world. But I tell you, be careful, because once you walk into this whole new world, it brings on some whole new emotions. This emotion you ain't, you know what I'm saying? You was numb to it before. Now it hurt a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it hurt not only, you know, fixing your own problems, but then it start hurting because you start seeing the problems that other people are dealing with. When it comes to this thing called lack of money or lack of resources, which really there is no lack, it's just a lack in your mind.